Blessed be the name of the Lord God Most High. This is the day the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. This is your brother and friend, Pastor Festus and Soha of Overseas Church in Prague in the Czech Republic, saying to you today, arise and shine, for your light is come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Every day the Lord has given to us is a wonderful and precious and amazing day. Every day is a gift. Life is a gift from God. Everything we have is a gift from God. We came into this world with nothing. We came in naked. I mean, Job said, naked I came, naked will I depart. So everything we enjoy, the sun, the moon, the oceans, the things, the birds, the flowers, the day itself, the moon, all the galaxies, they are all a gift from God. The Bible says every good gift and every perfect gift descend from above and come from the Father of light, with whom is no variableness of turning. So our God is a steadfast God. He is worthy of all trust. We can rely on him. We can trust him. He is a good God. He is an abundant and wonderful giver. So let's enjoy even this moment, this time, this short time today, he has given to us again to meet together and share his word. All we can do is to say, thank you, Lord, for the gift of this day, for the gift again of meeting again together to share your wonderful word. The Bible said, what do you have but only what you have received? We all we have is what we have received. All we enjoy, all we enjoyed, all we will ever enjoy, all we fight to get or possess or own is only but what God has given to you and I. So I wanted to know that in this hour, in this time, in this season, where this world is still going through this pandemic and crisis, it is very important to maintain a very thankful spirit. A very thankful heart. Thankfulness is very, very important in this hour. It helps your immune system. It strengthens your immune system to be thankful. The Bible says, and be ye thankful. The Bible says, in all things give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. You may look around you and say, oh, these days I don't have so much to be thankful for. No, if there's always something you can thank God for. Thank God you are watching me now. Thank God you can still hear. Thank God you can still see. Thank God you can still understand. Thank God you can still open it, have a television or your cell phone or whatever you have, and just be able to link in and connect with what you are hearing today. Everything we have is a gift from God. Even this hour, this time, this broadcast, this message today is a gift from God. And all that God wants for you and I is to be thankful. Stop complaining and be thankful. Complaining is negative. It will break down your immune system. It weakens your immune system. The virus that is being, the world is battling with this COVID-19 is something that attacks your immune system. So we need a strong immune system. And the Bible has provided us ways we can boost our immune system, boost our body's response and reaction to go at war against any invaders of our immune system. And being sincerely thankful to God is an amazing thing. So we need immune system booster. As I've said some time ago, medicine does not cure you. Even the vaccine that is trying to put out now, vaccine does not cure you of anything. All the medicine or vaccine can do is to waken your body up to fight, to produce antibodies to fight against the invader, the virus. So your body is actually what heals itself. Your body heals itself. Medicine, vaccine only helps your body heal itself. The vaccine or medicine just knocks at the door and say, hey, body, wake up. There's an enemy at your door. Wake up and fight him. And so the body then produces antibodies to attack the invading bacteria or virus or whatever they call it. So important. And one of the important way to maintain a strong immune system is to have a joyful and thankful heart, to be appreciative, to be thankful. This is very, very important. And so there's every reason for you and I every day in our life to be thankful, exceedingly thankful. Thankfulness will boost your immune system. It will boost your mind, your memory. It will keep you stronger and healthy and sound in every area of your life. Just being sincerely thankful to the Almighty God. In all things, give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you and I. Bible said, and be ye thankful. Bible said, you might show forth the praises of him who has called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. We are here on earth. If you are a child of God, if not yet, before this program is over, it is you give your life to Jesus Christ and receive a thankful heart. Sometimes everywhere you turn, you hear people complaining and arguing and quarreling and backbiting. They don't know that they are actually destroying themselves. Those things are breaking you down. You are sinning against your own soul. You are sinning against your body. Everything the Bible, God tells us in the Bible, is for our own good. It's for our own good. Spiritual, physical, mental, emotional. It is for our own good. And if we can, at this hour and season, where it seems as if there's not much to thank God for, begin to take up, have a thankful heart, a thankful spirit. You can thank your way out of the crisis. You can thank your way out of this season of pandemic where everybody goes gloom and dark and depressed and hopeless and fearful. You can have a thankful heart appreciating God every day for the gift of life, for the gift of today, for the gift of the air you breathe, your eye, your ear, your body, everything that is around, just thank God for the things that is outside there, the birds, the sky, the moon, the ocean, everything, just thank him. There is always a reason to thank God 24/7. Have a thankful heart. A thankful heart will keep you above the storms of life. And with a thankful heart comes a joyful spirit. You rejoice with joy unspeakable and full of glory. Hallelujah. So we must maintain a thankful heart. Not just thank God only. Thank your mother for the food he cooked for you. Thank your father for paying the bills. Thank the taxi driver that dropped you somewhere. Thank the policeman that helped, you know, protect you in your city. Thank the leaders. Be thankful for them. In all things, be thankful. Don't always complain and see only the negative side of everybody and everything. Did you thank your wife for the food she cooked today? Did you thank your wife for coming home and the room and everywhere is clean? Be thankful. Unthankfulness is unholy. Every unthankful person is an unholy person. Unthankful and unholy. All these people will end up in the lake of fire. They are unthankful. This is why the world is in crisis. This is why we are in trouble. This is why we are in distress. Because we have not thanked God. We have not been sincere as a nation, as a generation. We have focused ourselves on ourselves, our mind on ourselves. We think that the whole world should revolve around us. Everybody, everything should serve us. We are enthroned in our own little throne. And so if God, God didn't do it for me. God didn't do that for me. Why did God let this happen? Why did God let that happen? I don't want to believe. You are on the throne. And you become unthankful. And the moment you become unthankful, you begin to sink. This is the root of sin. Lucifer in heaven, God made him a beautiful, wonderful archangel. We beautified him with everything. And he was not thankful to God for making him an archangel, giving him a position, a place among the angels in the throne of God. He had access to God's glory and power and presence. He walked in the stones of fire and he was unthankful. Where there's unthankfulness, there's arrogance, there's pride. And when unthankfulness steps in, arrogance steps in, and then you welcome unholiness. And what happened is rebellion and idolatry. Unthankful person is a sinful person. Be thankful and give him praise. Praise God. Be thankful for the people he's using in your life, your pastor, the leaders, people in the church. Don't always see the negative side. You complain at job, you complain at the church, you complain at home, you complain on the highway, in the byway, and everything. Just complaining. That's not the right attitude at this hour. The winning attitude in this hour is to be sincerely thankful. And know that all you have is a gift from God. You came to this world naked, and soon you will leave without anything. And then, if you are not a thankful person, God will never let you into his heaven. If you don't thank God here on earth, you won't thank him in heaven either. So God wants to give us this earth, this time, this hour we live in, to see if we can even thank him in the midst of difficulties. Say with me, thanking God in the midst of difficulties. In all things, not for all of them, but in all things, in that situation where you are now. Thank him and tell him, say, Father, I know you are working things out for me more than I can even understand or imagine. I believe, God, by your mercy and grace, I'm going to come out of this stronger and better and more better in every area of my lives. Hallelujah to Jesus. So let's pick up a thankful heart. Let's show forth the excellencies, the perfections, the beauties and the glories of him who has called us out of darkness into his marvelous light. If you are a child of God, you know where God brought you out from. From the pit of hell. You were on your way to hell. You have no hope, no God, no covenant, no agreement, no covering, no protection, which should have ruined you, that eating your flesh up. But then came the gospel of Jesus Christ, and you were gloriously and wonderfully saved. Don't stop thanking. When you stop thanking, you start dying. Let's develop a very positive, thankful attitude in this hour and time. Let's conquer the virus by putting up a positive attitude. And the first one there is being thankful to God. Be thankful to God. Be thankful to God. Hallelujah. And I'll read that for you there in chapter 1 of the book of Colossians. Hallelujah. And verse 10 said that you might walk worthy of the Lord unto all pleasing, being fruitful in every good work and increasing in the knowledge of God. When somebody is very thankful, you open the door for more blessings. The more you we bear the fruit of thankfulness, the more we worship and thank God with the fruit of our lips, the more the doors are open for more knowledge. Nobody wants to give any unthankful person more opportunity, more chances. No. When you appreciate, when you are thankful to God and to those he has used to bless you, to help you, to encourage you. Have you ever thanked your mom for giving birth to you? Or you complain about, well, why did I have a big head? Why did I have a small ear? And so you complain about everybody. Why did I have an eye like that, an ear like that, and head like that? And so all you do is to complain. And that's not the spirit of Christ. You must wear that off today. And let the grace of God come upon you. Thank God that you can clean the toilet. There are people who have no hands to clean it. Thank God you can serve in the choir. Thank God he can clean the kitchen. Thank God you even have a kitchen to clean. Thank God from where you are and he will lift you up. Thank God for the small house. Thank God for the little place you stay. Thank God for the little car. Begin where you are and begin. You will thank yourself into greatness, into greater things. A thankful person is a person who shines and brightens. Always have a hope, even in a hopeless time. Thankfulness strengthens and quickens your immune system. It uplifts your spirit. And not only you, but those around you will feel the magnetic force and power of a thankful heart. We need something positive in our lives. We need something that is beautiful and glorious in this hour. Let's speak God. Let's speak mercy and grace. Let's speak power. God is good. He has never changed. He will always be good. His ways are perfect. We may never understand what he's doing. But after a little while, you're going to look back and say, oh, if I had known, I would have been more thankful even in the valleys of my life. Chapter 1 of the book of Colossians. And it says here, and strengthened with all might, according to his glorious power, unto all patience, long-suffering with joyfulness. This is the hour. God wants to strengthen you and I. The Bible said that in these last days, as men see what is going to happen on earth, their hearts begin to fail. Many people are failing. They are fainting. They are yielding themselves over to hopelessness, to depression, to frustration, to all forms of negativism. And they don't see anything ahead. They don't see anything good ahead. But I want you to know, if you can begin to thank God every day more than you complain, thank God for the food. Well, was it not bigger, better? Thank God for the dry bread. And He will give you a better bread tomorrow. I tell you, begin today. Change your attitude. Be thankful. Be thankful to the people around you. Be appreciative. Develop a thankful attitude. Don't complain about the salary. Thank first. Before you complain, before you ask for more. Thank for the little food and then ask for more after you've thanked. And thank your way out of trouble. Be appreciative and be thankful. And then God will strengthen you with might, according to His glorious power, unto all patience and long-suffering with what? Joyfulness. We are in that season where you and I need God to supernaturally strengthen our hearts. We are living in the midst of negativism and fear and anxiety and hopelessness. There's nothing positive coming out from the television, from the radio, anywhere you go, people you look at. I mean, it's almost like, well, this is it all. We're all ending here. Even if we're going to end, let's end thanking God. Even if you're going to die, die praising God. Even if you're going to lose everything, go through it praising and thanking God. Let God know that you thanked Him all the way. And you were appreciative and thankful. You did not complain. Shut down complaining. That complaining is a poison. It eats your being. It eats your immune system like a cement. It destroys your inner man. And it weakens you. God wants you and I to be strengthened with might in our inner man by His Spirit. Unto all, say with me, all patience. Long-suffering with joyfulness. That means we are able, by His supernatural power, to hold on under pressure without caving. We hold up by His grace, by His mercy, with a thankful, appreciative spirit. Go home and thank your wife. Thank your husband. Thank your son and daughter. Thank people. Be thankful. Thankful to God. Begin. Don't just ask, ask, ask. Begin with thanks. Begin to thank more than you ask. Thank more than you ask. Hallelujah. And God will strengthen you with all might in your inner man. Unto all patience, long suffering with joyfulness. Hallelujah. Giving thanks unto the Father, which had made us meet to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in the light. The more you and I become more and more engrossed, more and more drawn, more and more drowning in the ocean of thankfulness. Through thankfulness, we are able to have access to our inheritance. Thankfulness opens the door into your inheritance. Unthankfulness, complaining, bickering, bitterness shuts the door to your inheritance. Hallelujah. The key, the access key to your inheritance is thankfulness. It will shock you how doors will open, how the blessings will come, how your needs will be met. Because the key to accessing your inheritance is thankfulness. Ask God today to give you a thankful heart. A heart that appreciates. A heart. Don't think you are worthy of anything and everything. We always think everybody owes us. That we are that very important. We are so such a great person. We are all helping here. I'm doing this. So I'm so good. I'm so great. I'm so helpful. If not me, the world can't even survive. You are not God. Everything you have given to somebody is what you received yourself. So we should not have an attitude of, you know, look all that I'm doing. Look at all I have done, you know. As people say, well, look at all I've done for the church. Look at all I've done for the ministry. Look at all I'm doing for you, woman and man, you know. I cook for you. I do that, that, that. Oh, Lord God. And sometimes we even think that God owes us because look, all I'm doing for God, all I'm doing for God. And now look, this is where the devil gets you. I sowed seed, I prayed, I fasted, and now look what I got. So, well, I don't, And there you go, because you think it is you are to be paid for all the good man and woman you are. No, 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 no. We are not worth anything. You and I, we are worth nothing. God doesn't owe you and me anything. He doesn't owe us nothing. Everything we have is by his mercy and by his grace. It is because Jesus died on the cross of Calvary, redeemed us with his own blood, buried and rose again, and is alive. This is the only reason why God looks upon you and I with mercy and compassion and not with judgment. You see that? So don't always have that mind, oh, look what I'm doing. If not me, nothing will work. No ministry, no church, no government. I'm that. If not me. Oh, no, no, no. You are on the wrong way and to the wrong direct destination. Get back to a place where you feel yourself that you are worthy of nothing. And you can thank God for everything. So you can see everything as a gift. Don't say, oh, because I work so hard. You know, some people say, I have worked so hard, so I have to reward myself. I am the manager of the bank. Look all that I have done. So now I am worthy to take a bunch of that for myself because I am worthy of this. I have worked so hard. Don't let people praise you. Let God praise you. And don't praise yourself. For if God is to put you on the scale of eternal justice, you will fall empty. So let's be thankful. A thankful person is a person who have a humble attitude because he doesn't feel like he is worthy of anything. So he sees everything as a gift from God. Hallelujah to Jesus. Giving thanks to the Father, which has made us meet to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in light. Wow. God, it is by being thankful we have access. Say with me, thankfulness is the access key to my inheritance in the light. Thank him all the way. Thank him for Jesus. Thank him for the Holy Spirit. Thank him for giving you his word. Thank him for the blood of Jesus Christ. Thank you for his mercy, forgiveness every day in your life. Thank you for watching over you in the morning, in the day, in the night. You are not alive today because you're better than anybody else. Because you are that holy, you're that perfect. No, no, it is of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed. His mercy is new every morning. Great is his faithfulness. Praise the Lord. Giving thanks always for all things unto the Father, who had delivered us from the power of darkness and had transferred us unto the kingdom of his dear Son, in whom we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sins. What can you pay for the cleansing of your sins? You can't earn that. What can you pay for a pure conscience? For a cleansed conscience? For God forgiving you all your past and all your mistakes? If God is to bring all your sins and mistakes before you and judge you by them, then nobody in hell claims to be worthy of anything. Let's be thankful. Let's understand it is just his mercy. Thanking him for delivering you and I from the powers of evil. For keeping us alive. If God is opening your eyes and show you how much evil is around you that would have eaten you up and ruined you long, long time ago. But God's restraining hand kept you alive. Even when you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, his rod and his staff was with you to comfort and to preserve you. You have to understand that every blessing you have and whatever you are enjoying now, you are enjoying them actually in the very presence of your enemies. It will shock you why you think you're having a good time, how much evil surrounds you. It is just God holding them back. And a thankful heart that appreciates God's mercy every day and sees God's grace in everything will keep the fountain of mercy and love and life flowing your way. A thankful person will never be dry. You will blossom even in the dry season. You'll be like a tree planted by the rivers of waters that produces its fruits in its own seasons. Keep your heart and mind rooted in thankfulness. Thank him for the word every day, for the message of the cross, for the message of the word of God every day, for sending his word to your heart, to your life. And you'll be amazed how the doors of your inheritance will be opened and healings will come and blessing will come. And don't just complain, oh, I've been married now for 4 years and I have no child yet. I've been going to church. I've been praying. Oh, I'm no. Keep up that thankful spirit. Don't let anything break you or close that fountain of thankfulness and appreciation. You will thank your way into a baby. You will thank your way into a new house. You can thank your way into a new car. God will bring you out of trouble because you are thankful. God will never turn his ear and heart away from a person who bows and worships, who appreciates, who thanks him for every step of the way, who reminds God, say, God, listen, I know. If not you, I won't be here. I did not merit anything that I own or have. It is just your own amazing grace. When I read out the book of Revelations, I see there even the 24 elders, the heavenly Sanhedrin, they will always fall on the, take their crown out of their head, lay it down before the throne, and they worship, and they worship. And they worship. They will lay their crown down. They are saying, I didn't earn this crown because of my own righteousness. It is you, O Lamb of God, who died and shed your blood for my sins, that put this crown on my head. I lay it down and worship, and I cry, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, which was and is to come, the Almighty. Praise God forevermore. I pray that God restore back your joy and fill you with thankfulness for the rest of your life. Father, I pray today in breaking every heaviness, whatever weighs your people down, the voices of accusation and the accuser, every pressure laid on them, I command those yokes now broken in Jesus' name. Diseases and sicknesses, fears and poverty, be bound in Jesus' name. Call, write, take a photo, info on that screen. I want to hear from you today. Call, write, join us in prayer, and send your financial donations today. You have the info there on your screen, and I'll be very happy to hear from you. If you need to have any prayer topics or questions, whatever, send an email, write, call on the WhatsApp, whatever, you can get the info there, and we'll be very happy to pray with you and respond to your questions or whatever. We are here, and I believe God will keep us going on these programs, being able to pay the bills every week, every month, every year. God will provide, and I want to hear from you very soon. God bless you, and arise and shine, for your light is come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. Praise the Lord.